Đây là chương trình Khéo Dùng Tiền của Đài Lưu Rồi Sài Gòn TV. Chúng tôi là luật sư Tony Nguyễn CPA. Xin kính chào quý vị.
Dạ, xin chào quý vị. Tôi là Tom Nguyễn, chủ công ty Integrity Escrow.
Kính thưa quý vị, bấy lâu nay quý vị đã nghe chúng tôi bàn với quý vị về đề tài ngân hàng, vay nợ, loan, SV loan. Nhưng mà hôm nay chúng tôi xin được đổi đề tài. Chúng tôi mời được một người CEO của một ngân hàng ở trong cộng đồng của mình đến đây để bàn với quý vị về cách thức làm sao run một công ty, một ngân hàng một cách thành công. Đó là ông Jack Choi của ngân hàng Unity Bank. Ông ta là CEO cũng như là President của ngân hàng Unity Bank tại Los Angeles và Orange County. Jack, Mr. Choi, would you introduce yourself to the audience, please?
Yes. I'm Jack Choi, President and CEO of Unity Bank. We are serving Orange County as well as LA County. We have about $280 million assets serving commercial loans, SBA loans, and many different types of loans, as well as deposits. One of the philosophies of our bank is to diversify and help develop each other, especially the community development. And we, Korean American community, has grown so far, and we see some similarity here, and we want to share the same idea, also help each other to grow our community, eventually helping all the people living in the United States as a minority group. I'm very glad to be here to share some of the ideas we can help each other. Thank you.
Thank you and welcome, Mr. Choi.
Thank you.
Tom, would you like to start first?
Well, yes, thank you very much. Thank you, Jack. Thank you for taking time to be here with us. The topic of today's show is what takes it to be a successful CEO and an Asian American bank. So our question today is, at most Vietnamese, like most Asians, consider to be a CEO as to be a symbol, status symbol. Is that similar in Koreans as well?
Yes, very much so. Number one, United States has a very different unique system that we have many community banks. On the other hand, all the rest of the countries have a very large banking system. So number one, the banking used to be known as a big corporation. So that's one factor. Number two, banking is heavily regulated by the government. So there's no room for any of abuse or fraud. So whenever we are thinking about people working in a bank, we can give or bestow some of the trust level to the banking system. So that's why that many people respect bank and they can trust the bank. So it's so natural to have a status as a banker in any communities.
Oh yeah, absolutely.
That's true. That's the same. Yeah, it's true in the Vietnamese community. Mm-hmm. Owning a bank back in Vietnam or here in Little Saigon, owning a bank is a status symbol. But the issue in our community is, for some reason, Vietnamese banks have not succeeded as many Korean banks like yours. What did it take to run a successful Asian American bank?
Yes. Our community, especially Korean-American community, has some merit or advantage over your community because the Korean-American banks grew in early 1980s. Early 1980s, Korea, our mother country, was economically developing very soon, very well. So they could support growth of a Korean community, also growth of a Korean banking system too. But the Vietnamese community at the time, Vietnam didn't have a relationship with America, so you couldn't have the luxury of those support from the mother country. So it was kind of very, very isolated battle to succeed in the banking system here. In that regard, we think Korean Americans had some advantage over other, especially the Vietnamese community. The other thing is that I was involved a little bit of a first Vietnamese American banks here, and I thought it was a little bit unlucky that you couldn't secure many talents from your community because history was really short, and also there are not many correspondents from Vietnam in Southeast Asian countries. So Korean American banks got a lot of help from the former bankers in Korea. They immigrated to the States. So we already had a big pool of bankers from Korea. On the other hand, the Vietnamese American community at that time didn't have a lot of talent. So it was kind of unlucky, timing-wise.
So you think it was just timing-wise?
Yeah. Yes.
But you believe that, that Vietnamese might be able to be successful one day within our community to open another couple
well,
of more banks?
Well, that's why Mr. Exactly. Choi is here today.
Exactly.
We'll learn from him.
Absolutely, so. And positively. And I see the development here, that you have your community has grown quite remarkably. So the timing is much better than 20 years ago, 15 years ago. And also, you got a lot of 1.5 to second generations who were educated here, learned the American system. So you have a lot more chance to succeed in this time of the age in your community.
Very interesting.
Exactly.
Let me translate. This is very interesting,
yes.
I found, because you know, your number one point is, you know, you got support from Korea, South Korea. But the main thing is the immigrants from South Korea who came here, who were bankers in South Korea, who came here, studied here, and already had the experience and the training, and that's why they are more likely to succeed than Vietnamese.
Right.
Because we don't have Vietnamese immigrants from Vietnam coming here who used to work for banks.
Right.
So.
Right.
Kính thưa quý vị, ông Choi có nói một điều rất là hay. Ở đây chúng tôi không bàn những chuyện bên Việt Nam bên này, nhưng mà ông có nói hai điểm. Thứ nhất là ngân hàng của Đại Hàn thành công là tại vì có được một phần nào đó giúp đỡ của bên Đại Hàn. Nhưng mà điểm chính đó là một số những người mà chuyên viên chuyên gia của Đại Hàn
có tài bạc
là sang đây và làm việc ngân hàng bên này, đó là những người hồi xưa bên Đại Hàn đã làm ngân hàng rồi. Người Việt Nam mình không có được cái luxury như vậy, cho nên một số ngân hàng của Việt Nam mình bị thất bại như vậy. Very good point. Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, as a successful bank or Asian bank, did you just target certain clientele or whatever clientele so that you target or specific just to Koreans?
Yes, the most important part of the beginning stage of any bank is to have some support or rapport group. Banking business is more like a cultural business. It's not just a product business. Product business, you can go anywhere to buy just by paying for that product. But the banking business, we need a lot of conversation, a lot of understanding, and the building relationship and the building trust.
It's a lot of relationship, as you say.
Yeah. So when we don't understand the culture, it's very hard to build the mutually trustworthy relationship. That's why it's natural in the beginning stage of a bank, any ethnic banks, they start with their own ethnic groups. But once the bank is growing, and to a certain stage and a certain level, they can have some idea how to approach other communities too, because there's some common ground. So in the second stage of the banks, they grew into the non-ethnic people.
Mm-hmm.
Especially thinking about like a Vietnamese American community, we are all from same Asian culture. We share some kind of religious background. So there are a lot of things that we can share. In that case, we can have a synergy here that we went through the same history. So our cultural background and our assimilation history can blend in with the Vietnamese American community, because you are growing very fast. But it is kind of following the very similar pattern of a Korean American community too. So with that, in the second stage, we can go into the non-Korean American ethnic groups, and eventually it can cover most of the other ethnic groups too, including mainstream, like a Caucasian market too.
Is this where you're at right now, in more of the mainstream?
We are still in the second stage.
Second stage.
Yes.
I see.
Yes.
Interesting. Kính thưa quý vị, ông Choi cũng có nói là cái ngân hàng không phải như một công ty bán sản phẩm, là một cái business mà cần có sự giao thiệp, có sự có cái văn hóa riêng của nó, mình phải hoạt động chung với lại cái cộng đồng của mình, hiểu được cái văn hóa của mình trước khi mình bắt đầu mình expand trong cái thị trường khác. Thì ông Choi cũng có nói là ngân hàng ông đã qua giai đoạn đầu tiên, tức là đã cultivate được cái clientele trong cộng đồng riêng của ông ta rồi. Cái second stage, tức là cái dòng thứ hai của ngân hàng ông ta, là bắt đầu phát triển ra những cộng đồng khác. Như là you are now expanding to the other communities like the Vietnamese, the other Asian communities, as well as the mainstream American community also.
That's correct.
I see. Mm-hmm. Please pause here. We will come back after a brief commercial announcement.